What do you feel is the most important thing the public needs to know about what took place on 9/11?
Well, the most critical thing is clearly that this is a false flag, and really what is important about it is that this is the most effective tactic for the powers that be across millennia to manipulate us into war. So that's actually the blessing in disguise of 9/11, because while the powers that be have achieved all of their immediate goals, I mean, we know what the plans were with regard to 9/11. It was the, quote, new Pearl Harbor that was referred to in the Project for a New American Century, rebuilding America's defenses. People really want to know what is happening in the Middle East. They can read that document. They can also read another PNAC document, A Clean Break. These documents lay out very clearly what the agenda was, and in that agenda was this goal termed full spectrum dominance. So the goal was to achieve total control. The American Empire was supposed to seize the opportunity of the fall of the Soviet Union.
When the Soviet Union collapsed, this area, now they found oil and gas reserves in Kazakhstan, in Turkmenistan, in Tajikistan, in Uzbekistan, and Kazakhstan. This area was always under Russia. Now, the Soviet Union is out. America wants to get this oil. And guess what? American oil companies own 75% of the oil and gas reserves here and here. But what they needed was a pipeline that would go through here, through Pakistan, to the Arabian Sea into the Indian Ocean. Now they have to deal with the Taliban. What you don't know, that the Taliban, up until August, was seen as a source in this area of stability. Even though the women, they said, were oppressed and they were using the Sharia and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Now notice this. Afghanistan has never been said to be a terrorist nation. Go and check it out. The U.S. government has never said that this was a terrorist state. If it were, then she could not politically get a pipeline through there. She had to leave this one neutral and try to negotiate with the Taliban. And around July, they were meeting in Peshawar, here in Pakistan. And the American representative told, and this is before the Trade Center, told the Taliban leadership, either we give you a carpet, or you accept a carpet of gold. If you accept a government here that is a representative of all of the groups here, we will recognize you, we will give you aid, and you will have a carpet of gold. If you don't accept, we will bury you under a carpet of bombs. This is July and August. They had already planned a war with Afghanistan. Because the regime in Kabul would not let a pipeline come through there. Whether September the 11th happened or not, they were going to bomb Afghanistan. But it just so happened that September the 11th gave the government the cover that they needed.
thing is that false flags are not new, and that's what's important for people to realize. This is the tactic used to bring us into almost any war, and because people don't want war. They have to be conned into war. So that's the beauty and the blessing of 9/11. Not to dismiss the suffering of those who've lost loved ones and whatnot, but at the end of the day, we kill millions of dark-skinned lives all the time. We killed 1 million, 2 million people in Iraq alone. We've never even so much as apologized for that yet. We'll always hear about the just under 3,000 people who perished on 9/11. This reveals another thing that I think is extremely important, the disparity between the way we value our own lives, in particular white Western lives, as opposed to dark-skinned non-Western lives, which pretty much count for nothing. This is the world we live in, and it needs to change, obviously. This is a perverse reality. But for those that don't know, it's a false flag. The other interesting aspect about 9/11 is the cognitive dissonance, the literal mind control that prevents people from seeing the obvious, because the truth about 9/11 is all in the public realm at this point. You don't need to be a master researcher or some sort of intellectual genius to understand. You need to have a mind that actually functions and can think critically. And if you can do that, you see the truth. And around the world, people can see the truth. But in America, there is a bubble here. And I think people who revolve their attitudes around the American psyche and understanding make a huge mistake, because regardless of the 300 plus million that live here, there are 7 billion people on this planet, and they're not living in the American bubble. So hopefully the Americans can realize that in time.